Hello and welcome to Azure Wala YouTube channel. We are in part 49 of Microsoft Certified Associate series. So far we have completed 85 questions in previous videos. Today we are going to look into question number 86. You have an Azure subscription that contains 10 virtual machines, a key vault named Vault 1, and network security group NSG 1. All the resources are deployed to East US Azure region. The virtual machines are protected by using NSG1. NSG1 is configured to block all outbound traffic to the internet. You need to ensure that the virtual machines can access Vault 1. The solution must use the principle of least privilege and minimum administrative efforts. What should you configure as the destination of outbound security rule for NSG1? The question is very clear that what we have to configure is outbound security rule in NSG. So let's understand the scenario by diagram first. So as per our question, we will have virtual machines like 1, 2 and up to 10, but here we depicted 2 only, and each virtual machine would have its own NIC card, and this would be under the network security group, and that will be applicable over the subnet, because we can apply the network security group over a subnet and we can keep all the virtual machine in that subnet. So there is no restriction or stoppage for the inbound traffic, but for outbound traffic to internet is blocked. So this is not going to work from any of the virtual machine. Further, we need to connect with the key vault. So we have to find out that what should we configure in network security group. For that, let's check on the Azure portal what options we do have available on network security group. So let's move to Azure portal. We are in Azure portal. We'll go to our resource group and resource group 1. Under the resource group, we have network security group 1. We'll go there. And we can see here we do have inbound security rule and outbound security rule. So let's go to outbound security rule. For example, here we can add outbound security rule, and we do have options like the source would be the virtual machines from where the traffic will go, and destination can be a IP address. In case of key vault, we are not sure about the IP address, so we cannot use the IP address in this case. Also, there is no application security group is available on key vault service, so that also we cannot use. And definitely we can use a service tag, which is the predefined one, and in the service tag we can search our service. Let's say, for example, if we are working with the storage service, either we want to block it or allow it, we can select storage with region as well. So we can allow the storage service to be accessed by the virtual machines by using the destination service tag as storage, and under the destination we can use the service tag, and it will allow, or if we select the deny, it will deny all the storage service. So both we can have a rule in the place. So same way we can have key vault as well, and we can use the key vault with the region, or all the keywords we can allow to be accessed by any of the virtual machine, and we can either allow or deny, and we can add this rule. So this would be the outbound security rule. So in this case, for the question, we do have answer available as service tag, so that is useful. What other options? IP address is not useful because IP address is controlled by Microsoft for the Key Vault, and it can be changed anytime. So each time the Microsoft changes the IP address, we cannot change this. And also there is no application security group on the Key Vault services, therefore we cannot use this option as well. Back to our question, we cannot use the application security group choice in outbound security rule. We cannot use the IP address because it's supposed to change anytime and it is managed by Microsoft. Therefore, we can use the service tag and Microsoft takes care of the IP addresses behind that service. So B is the correct answer. I hope this video was informative for you. Please hit the like button, subscribe to my channel, and press the bell notification icon to receive the notification. Share with your friends. Thank you for watching. See you in next video.